No, no razor sharp
I'm
wits.
just playing a game as a kid in a onesie, tossing candy around,
You
talking to
talking to
weird things in a flower garden.
dude, is that a bird with like
He had no wings, don't even say bird.
it, he had like a feathery face though. Hi everybody. Welcome back to another fantastic episode of the Classic Game Couch. I'm here as always, Brett, with my good buddy over here, Keith. Keith, why don't you tell them what we're doing tonight?
Well, Brett, tonight we are playing one of my favorite Nintendo games in Little Nemo, the Dream Master. You're this little purple-headed boy in a onesie running around Dreamland
Onesie.
because you've been chosen to play with the princess.
Don't forget that wand on your back in your
Yeah,
onesie.
yep, I got a wand. I chuck candy at people. Well, I guess they're not people per se. They're more like.
Anthropomorphic animals.
Yes, that's a good description.
Look at
Because we got.
that. Dropping education out there in our
Yeah.
game channel.
Dropping some knowledge with some big words.
Dropping the K.
I mean,
Dude.
yeah, I'm throwing candy. I'm gonna be hopping in this frog suit. Now, I know you don't think it looks like a frog, but I don't.
That fin on his back is
Yeah, but
not
like.
froggish.
What else would you describe it as?
Some sort of
Yeah.
reptile dragon.
I think you should just stop talking right now.
I feel like after this episode, we are going to look this up and find out what he
What he
is.
is?
Yep.
Do you have the booklet for this game?
I might actually over there in the
Really?
pile. I'll have
Oh
to
my
look.
gosh. I just want to get up there and I can't. Terrible. Hopefully the rest of the game doesn't.
Fortunately, that infinite life is gonna come in
Yeah.
really handy.
Oh, we forgot to mention that. That we're being bads and in the interest of actually
Being bads.
trying to beat this game in a reasonable amount of time, we decided to throw in some Game Genie codes.
Yes, you heard it right, folks. Three codes or three wishes, if you will, to make the game bearable and
Game Genie.
endable.
Yep. I remember, like, a lot of games I could beat without Game Genie, but sometimes it was just more enjoyable, especially if they were really hard, to just have some, like.
And there are a lot of games like that. Like, some of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle games on the NES are basically not doable unless you had a Game Genie.
Yeah.
Especially that arcade version was. That game's just brutal.
What about Battletoads?
Right?
Battletoads can
Even with the
suck
cheat
it!
codes, you still can't beat that game.
Yep.
I mean, it can be done, you just have to practice at it, but
I just don't ever want to play anything that much in my life ever to be good at it.
So you're saying you're not going to become a speedrunner for Battletoads?
Oh my god. Is there somebody? Like,
I bet there is.
that's crazy.
There's a world of
I mean, I
champs out
believe
there.
it. There's
There has to be.
people doing crazy stuff all over the place, so sure. Somebody speed runs Battletoads. Oh, let's go down here. I gotta go down here.
Wow, that background is
The
like
waterfall,
seizure
yes?
inducing.
Oh man.
Look at the fin on the back of that thing, and you're calling that a frog suit.
Well, I want you to tell me what it is.
Not a frog. I'm going with dragon lizard thing. And that is a technical term.
I mean, I guess it can be anything. It is a we are in the dream world,
Right?
so we don't have to give it.
Let's call those things wasp drones.
Yeah, good call
Those
there,
things look like
buddy.
frogs down there. They're just missing their front legs.
Two-legged frogs?
Right.
I gotta get this lizard dude. What would you call him? Would you call him a
No,
salamander?
I
I'd call
like
him a
lizard
salamander.
dude.
You like lizard dude.
Purple lizard dude sounds.
Yeah. Yeah,
I
look at those
mean,
poor frogs. Somebody tore off
kingdom,
their front
phylum,
arms.
class, order, family, genus, species.
Sure.
He's in the species
Oh,
of
got all six
dude.
keys first time. Heading through the door. Crushing
G
it.
genus lizard.
Nobody wants to hear you trying to be smart, Brett. Just stop.
Aw, and here I thought they did.
Nope. Poor Nemo. He's
I
sleeping in.
guess they're just gonna have to get your razor sharp wit.
Ah, no. No, there's. I don't know about that, man.
No, no razor sharp wits.
I'm just playing a game as a kid in a onesie, tossing candy around, talking to weird things in a flower garden.
Dude, is that a bird with, like...
He had no wings, don't even say bird.
He had, like, a feathery face, though.
Yeah, but have you ever seen a bird without wings? I think you can classify that as...
Sure. A penguin?
It has wings. It just can't fly.
Dude, they're flippers.
Dude.
They might be wings, but they're flippers.
Just because you're wrong.
We're just going to misclassify all the animals everywhere while we play this game. It seems fine.
What's that guy? I'd call that guy a snake. And how about this guy? You think he's a gorilla?
Why do they all have sunglasses? Everything's got sunglasses.
What? It's bright out, man.
Like, that bird thing or whatever it was, sunglasses.
That guy?
The gorilla has sunglasses. Well, he doesn't have pants, but, you know, sunglasses.
Why not?
Exactly. It was that was the age.
These things don't have sunglasses. Whatever they are.
They look
I'd like you to tell me what that thing is.
Like I said, it looks like those white, puffy dandelions before you blow on them and...
Yeah, but what's the
spread
head
it all over.
Hanging down?
Dude, that's the obvious pumpkin outgrowth.
Alright. Oops. Now I gotta get Lizard Boy.
The pumpkin outgrowth.
And then...
Whee!
Yay. I kind of remember this game. Now it's bee time.
Dude, he's the best.
I love the bee. Look, you
know what?
Fly around, you can shoot stingers
there
out.
There is no question what that is, either.
We're I in don't the think bee. So.
We're in the bee.
I think he's a bee. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, not gonna make it. Yep.
Well, that bee came to the edge as if to mock you.
I guess so. One of the cool things is that if you do die, you get to keep the keys that you got already. You don't have to...
That is very helpful.
Yeah. Sure is. With all these snakes posing it. Aw, man, I still have to go up there and get
that. I like how there's mountains, like, up in the clouds. They could be clouds or they could be mountains.
That's just the distance, man.
I know. Well, I just stating because of the blue background. The NES did a good job with a limited palette for, you know, making the art work.
Yeah, I mean,
I was pretty impressed.
I think this game looks pretty cool.
Oh, this game is quite a lovely thing to see. It's got bright colors.
I gotta go up just to get.
It's got
this
a gorilla
lizard.
And a boy in a onesie and.
And I have a wand.
Whatever these things are.
Don't forget my wand.
Yeah, you have your wand.
Now I don't. I like how I can just poof make the animals that I'm riding disappear. See ya. Thanks for letting me use you.
It does seem pretty one-sided, doesn't it?
Yeah. I mean, well, they did.
And look at its eyes. It was still asleep while you're riding it, so apparently they're all sleepwalking while you're using them.
I think so. Like, you fill them up on candy.
And then they go into a sugar coma?
Yeah. And then you can use them as you please, I guess. Displace all their organs and just...
It seems like an awful experience for the animal. Oh...
But
dude,
I got that key.
Yeah. You almost had it, too, until you got hit.
You could see how, like, if you just wanted to go through this game and beat it without cheat codes, how it could be kind of difficult.
You'd get far and then get really frustrated because you couldn't make it.
I mean, I don't remember, actually, the game being that hard, because I used to beat it all the time without cheat codes. But...
That's the thing about when we were kids, like, you just have these fond memories even of things that were terrible, but you had, like, the time to put in the effort needed to do that, I guess.
Well, that's the thing, too, is, like, maybe I just don't remember how much I actually played at trying to do some of this stuff.
Mm-hmm. And that seems fair. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
It's tough now that we're adults.
Ah, I forgot a key. Dang it.
Oh. Wait, wasn't that...
I forgot it.
Wasn't there... You have to go up a tree or something, or...?
I don't remember. Oh, yeah, that guy drowns.
That guy is not amphibious.
Yeah.
He just straight drowned.
This salamander can't swim at all. I mean, to be fair, I don't think salamanders go in the water a whole lot, do they?
They mostly stay under, like, you know, wet rocks and whatever. Yeah.
Oh, there he goes drowning.
But I guess they don't really.
Who's this guy?
I don't know.
Me neither. Did I go down here before?
If you are an expert on salamanders or lizards, go ahead and leave a comment.
Oh, yeah, it's down here, remember?
Oh, look at that stump deal, yep.
A bat, a one-up, and a key. With every little
dream. Got the one-up and the key, good job.
Every little dream master needs.
A one-up and a key?
Yeah. Nice.
Made it out, good job.
Thank you. I'm about to beat this flower garden. Those guys are really annoying, like... It kind of reminds me of Mario 3, those guys that follow you around in the cloud and toss shit at you the whole level, and it's, like, super annoying.
And irritate the hell out of you the whole time.
And then you kill them, and they're like, oh, I'm gone.
I'll be back in 10 seconds.
Yeah, 5.5 seconds. How's it going? Let me continue to lob.
Yeah. Hey, did you need spiny crap thrown at you? Well, here I am to fill all of your dreams.
What would have been cool is if, like, when you killed him, you could hop inside the cloud.
Nemo, why are you out of bed? Get back to your room this instant.
Must be that Nemo wakes up in between dreams, and each time a dream is a different stage.
Still rocking that wand of no purpose.
Oh, there's a purpose, you'll see it, but you don't get to use it till the very end.
Dude, it just looks like a fashion accessory.
Pretty cool wand. When you're rocking a onesie and a purple hairdo.
Purple hair and a white one. That's it.
I want a pair of footy pajamas. I'm not gonna get them, but, you know, they do make them.
They
like,
do make
adult size
footy pajamas.
I mean,
once you're seen in those, you can't be unseen, but... That's the risky run, you know?
But people are buying all sorts of crazy stuff to be comfortable nowadays.
Dude, I mean, know, right?
People invented the Snuggie. That's a thing.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
It's just a blanket with armholes. See,
I actually
that's what
used
I would...
to. I used to have, like, this blanket that you could... It had, like, button snaps all the way around. But it was more like a... quilt, I guess. I mean, it was big and it was a thick, like, it was almost like a sleeping bag, except with buttons that you...
I kind of feel like had I had one of those, too.
I know. They were, like, early 90s. I think everybody had those for, like, 2 years, and then they disappeared. I don't even know if they still make them, whatever they were.
Who knows?
They were comfy, though.
Yeah. Most things that are comfy don't make you look the greatest, but at least they're comfortable.
There's one exception to that rule. The hoodie.
I guess.
The hoodie is comfortable, and it makes you look cool. Am I wrong?
I guess that would depend on the hoodie.
Well, if you want to qualify it, I suppose. I mean, I almost think Nemo's onesie has a hoodie on it in the back.
No, that's just my wand.
You sure?
There
What's
you
the
go.
Wand sitting in?
That could be your next... venture is making onesies with hoodies.
Seems like a $1 million gold mine.
Hey man, I bet people make money on stupid stuff like crazy. Like the
Somebody's
Snuggie. Whoever made the Snuggie made a lot of money, and all they did was like, hey, let's take a blanket and put some freaking armholes in it, and there you go.
Entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
I'm sure somebody's already probably done that, though.
Done what?
A onesie with a hoodie on it. You know, clothing things, they don't, you know, it's hard to be creative with clothes anymore outside of specific design, you know what I mean?
How did that hit me? That's super annoying.
I think it hit you because you put your head under it.
Oh, man, I need to
That's an observation, I'm just saying.
Beat this level, because I don't want to keep doing this stupid train over and over again.
And folks, this is why the game Genie is just clutch.
Yeah, because...
And yeah, I said clutch, you heard it.
At any
it back.
Point, if you want to beat a game and do it in a reasonable amount of time, You just gotta cheat a little bit, that's all.
you just gotta cheat, you know? Just gotta cheat to get ahead in this game.
Yeah. I mean,
I like that you can just skip the health.
Yeah.
Cheated.
It's pretty nice.
Dude, those planes are so annoying.
Yeah.
Like, if you didn't have the infinite life, those things probably would have killed us 18 times by now.
Probably. I mean, I probably wouldn't be past the first level, to be honest with you.
Right.
I just gotta start remembering some of the tricks. Like, that stupid guy, you have to get up there and... So he swoops, because if you wait too far back, he'll swoop down and make you, like, launch you into the spikes. And instantly kill you. Kind of a bummer.
I'm with Flying Squirrel.
Okay, we can agree on something. Frogs, good. No. Flying Squirrels, yes.
Yes. And not getting hit in the head by this falling ceiling is also something we are in full agreement of.
I'm gonna try, man.
Nice.
Let's try.
Look at you.
Yeah, buddy.
Wow.
I'll get that health. Oh, man, these things, they can knock you up. They can knock you in.
they can do what?
Well, they can, like, you know, not, like, get you pregnant, but hit you and make you bounce up into
the spikes. I was gonna say, that's quite the feat.
For an airplane. One, you're a little boy. Two,
it's an inanimate object
flying around.
There's a whole lot wrong with that equation.
Who knows? I guess strangers happened. Maybe
not. I don't know about that.
Yes.
All eight.
Yeah, but see, I guess that's the nice thing. They give you extra at the end just in case you missed some.
Yeah, because it's pretty tall ask in a game like this.
What happens if you don't have, like... You didn't get any
of the
keys.
It's not like you can go back.
And you roll up to that door and you're like, well, guess I'm boned. Restart
the
game.
Pretty much. The Night Sea, Dream 4.
Man, I'm crushing it.
Yeah, you are.
Yep. Ooh, look at this fuzzy little guy.
This is some sort of a monkey wombat.
He's kind of like got a beak. He looks like he's got a little bit of a beak, though, doesn't he? Maybe not. Maybe that's just a nose.
Monkey wombat bird?
All they do is show up and, like, give you clues to, like...
Tell me you can dig in that sand.
Yeah, you can, because you can be a hermit crab, man.
Outstanding.
Who wouldn't want to be a hermit crab?
There's a question for the audience. Go in the sand, I want to see it.
And there I go.
That is hilarious.
It's pretty sweet. You can use my claws, too.
Oh, look at them. Look at the pincers.
Here I go. I don't know if you can actually go. I think you can go down.
Do it.
Yeah, nice.
Oh.
Well, I don't know what these tree things are, man. They just, like, show up.
Hit them with the pincers.
Got them.
Nice.
They're hanging out in these caves that somehow are anti-gravity because that sand doesn't...
Or
dive down.
And then you're just gonna show up on top of the boat.
Yep. Well, it is a dream. It doesn't need to make sense.
Fair enough.
Not that games really need to make sense anyways. Right?
This one in particular, though.
Well, you're in a dream. Anything's possible.
Right. I feel like we missed a key somewhere already.
There's a chance.
I've been known
to do that.
I've been known to skip a key or five.
I can't remember everything. You know how long it's been since I played this game?
I grant you.
Whoa, pufferfish.
I don't suppose you can get in the pufferfish, can you?
No.
It would be pretty boss if you could.
Yeah, probably. There's a key.
There's one of those.
I wish there was like an indicator that let you know
how many keys you're supposed to have.
Yeah, at a certain point.
It would help.
Oh, that's what that whole thing was just getting that key. Cool. I don't like those things. They're trying to get me, trying to skewer me. Oh! See what happens when you distract me? Don't distract me, son of a gun.
Listen, I'm just trying to bring your best game out. That's all I'm doing.
Yeah. Oh, you can get in this guy,
get
though.
Get in the punch fish.
Yes.
Oh, get in punch fish.
Crawl into your spine, buddy.
Dude, tell me you can just deck somebody right in their grill with his fist.
No, you can't punch.
What?
Yeah, they gave him these massive fists, and they're
He's got giant beef fists, and you can't punch?
Nope. They're like...
Oh, that's just BS right there.
Oh, come on. Oh, man, these spikes are ruining me.
And it's like the same spot, wasn't it?
No. I was in a different spot. Like, I don't even know why they give you this guy right here. Because you can just come in here, not even get him, and you have to hop out of him anyways because he can't get out of the water. And then you have to get in your frog. It's a frog. It's definitely a frog.
So, I don't know.
And then... You know what? I wonder if I can go a different way.
try getting in punchy fishing, like going down.
That sounds good. Because that punchy fish makes it really nice for swimming. He doesn't punch anything, but he definitely helps you swim. Kind of like the frog suit in Mario 3.
How are you, like, riding in his back like he was a car? I don't get it.
I don't know, man.
That seems a little odd.
Somehow you just feed animals candy and then you can mutilate them. And turn them into vehicles, and they don't care.
Hey, punchy fish, he's just gonna dig out your back and then ride your back.
There's a key down there.
Gonna have to have that one.
Yep. Candy.
It's a good thing hermit crabs love candy.
Yep. It's a good thing all animals seem to love candy. And you only use them for a second. Like, I had to get out of there just to, like, swim up, because the hermit crabs can't swim.
Those mythical creatures love their candy.
Oh. I don't think hermit crabs are mythical creatures, but sure, Brett. Oh, the spikes! The spikes!
This is the biggest problem you have in the game.
Oh, the spikes. Oh, the spikes. They make me so sad. Yeah, take that. But, you know, that doesn't actually even help you. Like, you just pause them slightly.
Right. It's just a stun shot.
Thank goodness I have this whatever I'm breathing out of. Conch shell?
I don't know.
I missed a key. Oh no, I got them all!
Look at that.
Boom! Did it! Level 4!
It was easier than I thought it would have
completed.
Been.
Completed. Yeah, these levels aren't real long. Like...
Yeah. But on that, folks, alright, we're going to call this one an episode, and we're going to pick up and hopefully finish this up in episode 2. So as always... We love the likes, the shares, and the subscribes, and any comments. Working on some updates, so you know, keep your eyes out. We're hopefully going to have a Facebook page up and going for this and some other pieces like that. So keep your eyes open and keep the subscription, and we'll keep posting them up. So until next time, take it easy.